Welcome to raigurukul.com. In this video, we'll discuss about how to test LinkedIn portal in detail. At the time of testing of LinkedIn, if you can see, there are too many contents are available in LinkedIn, and this is popularly applications for connecting with the business people or connecting with the professionals. For testing this, we have to make sure we need to cover each and every components in detail. So we'll see here which all corner cases we have to cover in at the time of testing LinkedIn applications. So if you're visiting this channel first time, please hit subscribe button and don't forget to share within your circles. And if you want to learn about software testing, please watch my testing playlist. This will help you to understand from scratch. First, we have to navigate into the home sections. In home sections, we have first options this as a post. So to start a post, either we can select on photos. So once we'll select on photos, this will navigate is the folder from where we can select the file. Then we have these two buttons. Selecting images to share is one of the options that are also available here. Apart of that, we can also click on video. For posting a video, we can select the video sections. So whatever the contents it is navigating on selections, that should be exactly same within the line. Now, next one is to post on job. We can also create a job post with a hire fast, job title, company name, workplace type, and different other details, locations. These all details will be required for posting a job. Then if you want to write an article, we can also click and start writing the article and make it public so that the user who is having the account in LinkedIn pages, they will be able to see that content. So this is a home sections. We can see here we have to verify this LinkedIn news. So exactly same thing will be appeared here. Days, how many days it was there to be printed, then the readers details, then the tech and startup news roundup, offshores close, and IIT students. So these are the news sections. We can also have ad sections. So in ad sections, you can see the different ads are popping up. Then here we have different options like about, accessibility, help center, privacy and terms, ad choices, advertising. In the left panel, we have the images. So once we'll click on the images, this will navigate into the profile page where we can see different options like edit to upload a new images in the background. Then we have open to add profile. For testing this manually, we have to make sure we can consider each and every navigation link. So whenever we are clicking that navigation link, that should be diverted to the different sections. So here we can see this will be navigated into the different sections. Now, if I want to click on open to, it will navigate to find a new job, hiring and providing services. Then we have follow up screen where we can follow the different users. If we want to connect with this any professionals, once we are clicking on connect option, this will navigate into the next portions to send out the message with that person. Then if we have achieved any awards or recognitions, we can also make a post from here. So this is how we can test it. So once this will be added, the complete details will be highlighted in home sections or in profile section itself. Now, if you want to see the regular post, the regular post will be available here. We have different options like save, copy link to post, embed this post. These options should be required to be tested, and exactly the same thing when we are doing or performing this actions, this action should navigate into the next screen and that should be perfectly working fine. If we are clicking on like button or commenting on that, that comment or like should be available. So whenever people will click on this options, generally the people who like the post, that should be visible here. Then we have share options and send options. Even we can attach some images and emojis from the comment sections. So when we are ha watching any a post from the other users, that post should be clearly visible. And if you want to see the video and different other links or navigations, we can exactly see the different navigations should be also available. Now here, when we'll scroll down, that images should be clear, and the post which is written by the other users, that should all be also clear. So this is how we can test in the home sections. In my network connection sections, we can see all of the followers or connections who has attached with us. Then if you want to see the invitations which we have received, so we will see here in invitation section. So for doing this, here we have ignore options. If I'm clicking on ignore, that invitation should be removed from invitation board. If I am selecting accept, that invitation should be added into my connections list. And exactly same, the connections who had this recently attached, we can also get an options to connect with their other connections list. Even we can follow it on for clicking follow button, and if you want to click on connect, that person will be connected with us. Now if you want to see all 32 or maybe all invitation list, we just have to click on that and this will be navigated into the board. So generally when we are testing this type of applications, we have to make sure that images should be clear, video should be clear, the post which is created by the other user, that should also be clear, the post which is created by us, that should be clear and visible to the end user. Now here, if you want to click on connections, and we are sending a request of the connection, and once the person will accept our connection request, so we are getting an invitations mail or notification email to our email box. So generally if we have enabled it from the settings, that should be also tested. So notifications for creating a post, and if someone clicks on add comments or hit on like button, so probably we are getting in notifications messages, totally depending on the settings which we have set it up. So we have to verify that as well. If we are creating a post and someone has tagged or shared, we can also get a notification. So if someone has created a post and they are tagging to our account, then also we should get a notification scheme. So these are to and through processes to require to be tested. Then we have a connections. If you are clicking on the connections, so those who have the connection with us, they will be available with us. Then people follow, contacts, group, events, these all navigation links should be required to be tested. Even we have messengers options. So with whom we have chat, we can also test it. So the text which is shared by the other person, that should be clearly visible, and whatever we are sharing, we should also see that. Then we have edit options and the three dots which connects the manage conversations, messaging setting, and message request inbox. These also require to be tested. Then we have job sections. Whenever we click on the job sections, it will navigate it to the job portal where we can see the regular job posted by the organizations or enterprises. So if we are applying that to this job section, so we should get a notifications once they will update the job board. Here we have job alert, salary, skill assessment, and we can add suggested job search. Now in messaging sections, we can see all the messages are available here. We can also see it from the sections. In notification scheme, whatever notifications we have posted, created a post, or someone has tagged, if any actions will be performed by the other user, we can also test it. Then we have profile options like settings and privacy. Settings should be thoroughly required to be tested, where we have too many options to be tested. So for testing this type of applications, it's not an easy, and generally this will not take a smaller time. So we have to spend too much time here for testing this if you want to test it manually. But it's always suggested to automate these type of processes on the regular, because these type of portals will be updated on the regular basis. So if we require to be testing on the every instances or every releases, that should require the automation in place. So if we have the automation in place, we can churn it out on easily basis. So that's all how we can test LinkedIn website or applications in detail. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so, this will be useful, don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.